Sit up. Yeah. Sit calm. Yeah, boy,
all right. This is 2 Chronicles 15 and 13. It says that whosoever would not seek the Lord power of Israel should be put to death, whether small or great, whether man or woman. Yeah, man, if you don't want to seek the Lord, you're going to get put to death, man.
Basically, right.
Man. Whether you're a man or woman, small or great, whether you got a business or you don't have a business, man. If you're not coming on these highways and byways and pushing this truth and condemning these people, man, these wicked demons, man, you're going to get put to death, man.
Right, because you don't have no use. The Most High don't have no use for you.
That's right.
If you're not out here offering your body as a living sacrifice and bring it down, man, somebody give me Jeremiah 1 in the 5th chapter. If you're not doing this, hey, you worthless, man. You're 1 in 5.
If you're only doing it when you want to.
Right.
When it feel good to you.
When it's convenient.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? When you ain't got something else going on in your personal life, then I go serve the Lord. Nah, I'm also, I ain't dealing with that shit, man.
Right.
Everything else is secondary. Your kids, your wife, your job, all that shit is secondary to this, man.
That's right.
If it's not, then let your job save you.
Yeah.
Let your house save you, man.
That's right.
Let your kids save you then. This is what's going to, hey, y'all by Shimmy, y'all shy to save you. So your first duty is to him.
Right.
And if that's not the case, hey, just lay around for it and let the Lord judge between me and thee. Let's see who's righteous. Let's see who got their priorities in their proper perspective.
That's right.
I'm about to say, the reason why the Lord is supposed to be your first priority is if you're part of that, you his first priority, man. He's trying to get you out of here.
That's right.
So if you can't put him first, then 9 times out of 10, he's not fucking with you, man.
There you go.
Right.
No. It's plain. Yeah. It's plain. It's like, if you can't put this first, that means this probably ain't for you. Straight up and down, because if it was, you would understand the severity of this. You understand America is going to be destroyed very soon. Very, very, very soon.
That's right.
At the end of this year, life could be totally different from what we live in today. At the end of this year, if not next year.
Or before the end of
right,
this year.
Right, before the end of this year. You know, we just being optimistic. We hoping that this shit be destroyed tomorrow.
That's
right. So our people don't have to walk around like chickens with their fucking head cut off. That's saddening to see the people on this side walk around like assholes, man. We want America destroyed so we can rule. That's the moral of the story, man.
That's right.
When America is destroyed, the people on this side rule the earth.
That's right.
Is that so hard? But you know what? Our people don't have a ruling class mentality. Why? Because they have Stockholm Syndrome. Like you take a slave and you whip him and beat him in the shape. And then after a while, like a caged bird. A bird be in the cage so long, you open the door to the cage, the bird don't even want to fly out because he's so accustomed to being in the cage. And that's why we come out here to break down those strongholds, man. To tell people, look, this is not life. If you think this is life, you're in for a rude awakening. Where that sign at, Op? That's what's coming to America.
Right.
America will soon be destroyed by nuclear fire.
Right.
So why are you okay here? Why are you happy? And we, hey, that's just not word of mouth. We can validate it with the scriptures, which is the number one prophecy, the only prophecy book in the world, man.
Real quick. Go give me that Jeremiah. It's Jeremiah 1:5. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou camest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee.
Right, and that's what all us had to come to grips with. You know what I'm saying? Because none of us thought in life we'll be out on the street preaching the Lord's word. None of us. All of us had dreams. Some of us had hoop dreams. Dreams to be producers, rappers, football players, basketball players. None of us fathomed that we'd be doing this. But the Most High said, before he formed you in the womb, he fashioned you to be in this, to walk in this walk, man.
That's right.
Go ahead.
And I ordained thee a prophet unto the nation.
Right, he ordained thee to be a prophet to the nations. Go ahead.
Then said I, Lord power, behold, I cannot speak, for I am a child. But the Lord said unto me, say not, I am a child, for thou shalt go to all the for thou shalt go to all that I shall send thee, and whatsoever I command thee, thou shalt speak. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord.
Right. So we don't care. We know the whole world is set against us, but we come out here every week. We don't give a shit, and we don't lose no sleep, or we don't think twice about it.
Nope.
We don't care. We had a, you know, the goddamn that march, that bullshit march, the woman's march,
yeah.
We ain't give a shit. We were cursing them people out, man. We don't give a shit. Why? Because we know the angels of the Lord encamp around about us. And you can't come against this. Period.
And we speaking upright.
Right.
We speaking the right words. We speaking the 100% truth.
It's nothing perverse about what we saying. It might sound harsh, but hey, our Lord was an austere man.
That's right.
The person that the world ignorantly called Jesus Christ, he was stern. He was rough, man. So we coming in that same light. We rough. And the reality is, women don't want no soft ass man. That's why you niggas gonna be destroyed, man.
That's right.
This is 2 Esdras 15:1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the word of prophecy.
Right, the words of prophecy, man. Not the words of soothing or prosperity. It said prophecy, man. Telling our people, look, the Most High is coming back to destroy 2/3 of his people, man. That's prophecy. America gonna be destroyed, man. This way of living, faggots and shit running up and down the street, that shit is over with, man.
Right.
That's prophecy. Go ahead.
Which I will put in thy mouth, saith the Lord. But did not the Lord just say in Jeremiah, whatsoever he commanded thee, that shall ye speak, man? So the Lord commanded us to come out here, man. He put those words in our mouth, you know? And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. Fear not the imaginations against thee. Let not the incredulity of them trouble thee that speak against thee. For all the unrighteous shall die in their unrighteousness. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. All right? So we're not supposed to fear their unbelief, just like the scriptures say, you know, in Jeremiah, back at Jeremiah 1
and... Right. And we do. We don't. We don't give a fuck if you don't believe. If that was the case, we would... Hey, because... Miami, like I say every week, the stupidest people in the world reside in Miami. In the world. Fuck the United States. In the world. Nobody hearkens to this truth, man. Nobody walks by and sees this as a spectacle. Even though it is. But no, these people don't see it as a spectacle. They look docile like a motherfucker, man. Walk up the street. Nobody inquires. Why? Because ain't nothing but folly all around them, man. Folly, well, like I said earlier, folly is said in great dignity, man. I'd rather go drink tequila than to hear why that sign say America would be destroyed. So why, when I'm a resident of America, don't you want to know why? Okay, maybe these guys bugged out, but let me figure out why they got it up there, or why they got a sign with a chain around a so-called white man's neck. Why is that, man? Simple ass niggas, man. Go ahead,
I got Jeremiah 1:8. Be not afraid of their faces, for I am with thee to deliver thee, saith the Lord. Then the Lord put forth his hand and touched my mouth. And the Lord said unto me, behold, I have put my words in thy mouth.
Right, and these his words. It's not hard, man. It's the Holy Bible. It ain't like it was something mythical and he had a ball of words and it's a little bubble and he just put it in your brain. No, it's the Bible, man. God damn, go ahead.
There was a typewriter and
yeah.
You know, had the little cord connected to the back of the head, just typing.
Typing, yeah. Like got you plugged in like the Matrix and then program your brain. Nah, man, these scriptures, man, which we study diligently, man.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Verse 10, see, I have this day set thee over the nations.
Right. See, this day I have set thee over the nations, man. So the prophets are over the nations, man. Why? Because the scriptures tell you, since before the beginning of time, the Most High used his prophets to bring down civilizations. Go ahead.
And over the kingdoms, to root out and to pull down.
To root out what this wickedness and all this bullshit, the ones that sign and crying, that's what the prophets are doing. We rooting that shit out and to pull it down. Like, so through the words we're spiritually speaking, we're pulling America down, man.
Right.
And we see it. Every day we wake up, something new, something more spiritually satisfying we see it on the news. Yeah, oh, you niggas can't smoke your recreational weed no more. Right. Trump finna do away with that shit. They ain't gonna be legal no more. You bitches can't get all these food stamps and have all this Section 8 bullshit, man. Just letting us know this shit is on the way out, man. And rightfully so, because this is not life. Go ahead.
to root out, to pull down, and to destroy, and to throw down, to build, and to plant.
Right. To destroy, to throw down, to build, man. And that's what we're doing. We're building up the nation of Yahshua, because where's the kingdom of heaven dwell? Within us, man.
No pictures.
So when we come out here, that's what we're doing. And that's in a nutshell. We're throwing this shit down, we're rooting it out, we're building up, and we're destroying.
And we plant, because we're planting that seed, man.
Yep. Go ahead, come on.
This is 2 Ezra, chapter 2, verse 1. Thus says the Lord, I brought this people out of bondage and gave them my commandments by my servants, the prophets, whom they would not hear, but despised my counselors.
Right, and the scripture said, my servants. Who are the Lord's servants? Not these nasty pork-eating bitches in the church house with them big-ass, foo-foo-ass hats on, man. You're not his servants. His servants are prophets. And the word prophet go back to preaching, man. And what does the word preach mean? To say before. Pre and chair, to say before. Prophet, to say before, man. That's the Lord's servants. They're not saying what's going to happen before it happens in them raggedy-ass churches, man. Go ahead.
The mother that bare them saith unto them, go your way, ye children, for I'm a widow and forsaken. I brought you up with gladness, but with sorrow and heaviness have I lost you. For ye have sinned before the Lord your power, and have done that thing that is evil before him.
Yeah, so the Lord brought us up. He gave us law, statutes, and commandments. He sent out the prophets to teach us. And we just said, man, fuck your prophets. Yeah. We're going to do what we want to do, man. Yeah. We're going to continue being faggots, lesbians, bucking up to the prophets. No matter how rough the prophet come, if he tell you something, man, you think he the man of the Lord, he coming through the spirit of power. Man, how about shooting out a shot, man? But niggas just choose to buck up and say, I'm going to do as thy will, man. So the Lord going to do as he will, and he going to fucking kill you niggas, man.
That's right.
Even with niggas who know they Israelites.
That's right.
They gonna do this too how they wanna do it, when they wanna do it, man. I got a precept. This
is a lot, and that's who we gonna start with. Cause the 2/3, yeah. Fuck them. They little rocks on the ground, man. The Most High ain't worried about them. But you niggas that know you Israelites, man, and ain't doing the bidding of the Heavenly Father, he got a bone to pick with you, man. Cause it's like you done got the juice, which will make it, cause St. John 8:32, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. So you gonna obtain this truth and then do what the fuck you wanna do with it? Nah, man. He got a bone to pick with you. That's why I say, hey, what's that in Peter's? Where it say it had been better for them to not have known the truth than to known it? Because you gonna be in derision, man. All them pseudo-Israelite groups, you know what I'm saying? And niggas that's a part of GMS. All you niggas that thinking that this shit a game, you gonna be in a quandary, man, because you gonna thinking that the Most High dealing with you. And you're going to get fucked up worse than a 2/3, man.
That's right.
Why? Because you didn't understand the severity of this, man. That's right. Like we read in Jeremiah, he set us over the nation. The prophet, that's the dude, that's the heaviness of this walk we've been called to, man. So you got to look at it as such. Nothing else matters but this word, man. Everything else is secondary.
Sirach chapter 27, verse 3. Unless a man hold himself diligently in the fear of the Lord, his house shall soon be overthrown.
Right.
Yeah, so if you ain't holding yourself diligently, if you ain't coming out here knowing you're supposed to be out here, you got other things a motherfucking do, then come out here or read your scriptures it's too grievous for you to follow orders. The Lord gonna overthrow you and your whole fucking house, man.
That's right.
And if you watching the videos, you see dudes who know they're Israelites, dudes who done been in Great Millstone, who done got ousted and bugging the fuck out.
Dudes that was so-called diligent. Dudes that were heavy into this word, man. That nigga element, man. We used to call this man smart dude. Now look at him, man. Looking like a million birds took a shit on his face, man. He fucked up, man. Why? Because he wasn't doing what he was supposed to do, man. Plain and simple, we got the blueprint. But you niggas want to make a name for yourself, man. You're going to make a name for yourself. You're going to be called Mr. ICBM.
That's right.
That's the name you're going to make for yourself. Go ahead, Lloyd. That's it on that.
This is 2 Corinthians 5:9.
Wherefore we labor, that whether present or absent, we might be accepted of him. Verse 10, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Yahweh Shai.
All. We must all appear. Go ahead.
That everyone may receive the things done in his body according to that he hath done, whether it be good or bad. Knowing therefore the terror of the Lord, we persuade men, but we are made manifest unto God, and I trust also are made manifest in your conscience. Okay, so like the brother was going into, man, that's why we labor in this truth, man. And if you're not laboring in truth, when Yahweh Shai comes back, he gonna judge you for not laboring for him, man. Okay, because when Yahweh Shai comes back, he's coming back to judge everybody for their works, whether it be good or evil, man. And that's why we come out here through the terror of the Lord to persuade men, man. A lot of times it comes out rough, man, but it gotta come out like that because the prophets came out like that, man. Okay, and that's what a lot of times leads us to repentance, man. The fear of the Lord, man. That's the beginning of wisdom, man. Okay?
You can't save somebody by being soft with them, man. Like I always use this analogy. If somebody fall off the cliff, you're not gonna say, hey, man, stop walking. You might fall off. You'll be like, hey, bitch, chill. Look where the fuck you're going. You're gonna be rough with it, man. The same thing. You're bringing out these prophecies, being rough with it, because that's what it's supposed to be said, man. Just like Paul said, God be rooted in speech, not in knowledge, man. Because there's a certain way you gotta wake people up. You motherfuckers always call it fear tactics, but guess what, man? You're supposed to fear the Heavenly Father, man. Allah shot you, man. If not, the terrible demon-like power gonna put your ass to fucking death, man.
That's right.
It's that simple.
How do you not fear somebody that can kill your spirit, man? Which he won't do, but he can if he wants to. How do you not fear him, man? Which the majority of our people don't do. You don't fear the Heavenly Father, man.
That's right.
If you fear him, it's gonna show. Are you out here diligently? You fear the Lord. It's the fear that's gonna make fear the Lord. That's gonna make you stop doing shit. Make you put shit to the side for you to make sure that you do His work. Otherwise, you just bullshit, man.
And I always say it, Salaka, you cannot bullshit the Heavenly Father. The person that watches over the whole world and has millions of angels watching, you can't bullshit him, man. You bullshitting yourself. And real soon, you're going to find out. You're going to be, hey, because like the brother was saying, become harsh, but isn't food famine harsh? Is that harsh?
Yeah.
Is a food famine harsh? Or is rape harsh? When civil unrest breaks out and it ain't no police, and you see women on the streets getting raped, is that harsh?
It's harsh.
Right? Or men going back to that ancient state of mind, which I want what you have and I'm going to take it and then nobody going to stop me and I cut your fucking head off. Is that harsh? That's harsh. So that's why we, hey, because really it's love. We telling you, look, the Most High is the king of terrors. If you don't get right, hey, it's an innumerable amount of ways that he can put you to death. So it's no smooth way of saying get right or die. What's the smooth way of saying that?
Get right or die.
Right.
That's harsh.
Right. That's what I'm saying.
That's God.
Right. There you go. Right. King of Terror. Go ahead, Jeremiah.
Jesus.
You got near Jesus.
Jesus didn't say.
This is 1 Peter 4:17. It says, for the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of the Most High.
Right, and this is the house of the Most High. You see this sign? You Negroes, you Haitians, you West Indians, you Dominicans, Guatemalans, the Panamanians, Puerto Ricans, Cubans, North American Indians, Seminole Indians, Argentinians, and Chileans, Colombians, to Uruguayans, and you Mexicans. That's where the Most High gonna start with his judgment, and we seeing that shit. We seeing it over there in Venezuela and Mexico, man. And you niggas getting shot down by the police officers, man. And you niggas, hey, and you niggas catching all type of diseases, getting cancers that you can't even pronounce. We seeing it, man.
And if it first begin at us, what shall the end be of them that obey not the gospel of the Most High?
There you go. And more precisely, the house of the Heavenly Father are the men that know their Israelites.
Right.
The men that know their Israelites and know they're supposed to keep the law, statutes, and commandments. It's going to start with those niggas. So the rest of these people don't stand a chance.
Yeah, that's talking about those who follow. Niggas who follow, so-called follow GMS, but so-called follow any other mother groups. IUIC, you got nerve to talk about a brother who actually come out here on the streets and prophesy week in and week out. The scoffers, them people who know they Israelites, that's where it's going to begin at. Because the Lord going to bring down their destruction for all of us to see and make them be ashamed before all of us.
Verse 18, it says, and if the righteous scarcely be
saved, if the righteous barely make it out of here, barely, skin of our teeth, man. That's why we can't never say, oh, I know I'm finna make it out. You can't say that shit, because the scripture, that means you speaking against the scripture, and really, that means you don't need a savior. Because you know you righteous, you know you're gonna make it out of here. He said, the righteous shall scarcely be saved. That means Apostle Tahar scarcely gonna be saved. Lord willing, he probably elect, man. So how the hell are you gonna say, I know. They say the righteous scarcely gonna be saved. Go ahead.
It says, and if the righteous scarcely be saved, where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear?
Right. Ooh. And that got, I know the answer to that, in the lake of fire, man. That's where you're gonna appear, man. I see you.